What are you doing to me, Gordon?
That's a bit busy on the bench, but we'll get there.
Okay, so I'm a little nervous here. We've got tons of stuff going on. Everything around us is a bit hectic, so I'm going to panic early and slip the old glasses on and ask you the question. I don't know if I want to know the answer. What are we up to today, Gordon?
Well, Gary, we had some criticism about the quality of the lighting on our set, which for me is a bit embarrassing having a bit of a lighting background, so I thought I'd best do something about it. But first, I thought I'd best start with some nice shelving so we can put things on it.
So you've got this shelving here, and I know how you like to buy from that famous online retailer that offers next day delivery, but I've got a feeling you didn't order them from there.
No, I've just recycled some bits of tray and Unistrut we had lying around the workshop to build a solid steel shelving.
Well, you were talking about lighting at the start of the video, and now you're talking about shelving, so how would you link the two together?
Okay, well, good shelf lighting will help, nice in the background, but because that's all built from steel, so actually when it comes to the installation, we're going to use a brand new connector system from Unibox called the Konnect Hive, and that's going to really speed up install when we get to that stage.
Right, so because it's metal, you've got a system that's going to be easily installed on there. So we went up to see Nick Wraith up at Manchester. We had a fantastic time, Gordon. Talk us through some of the processes that we saw there, and you can also see them in another video that we've got on the channel.
Yeah, so Unibox is literally a hive of innovation. There's always something great to look at there. In that video, we looked at their edge light technology and some of the stuff for backlighting signage in a retail area.
Okay, so he's taking it on to one step further. So if I just move on to my hand cam, so if I press that there, this stuff here that's stuck to this metal enclosure is obviously where you're going to take me on this video, and you've got a profile in front of me. Now the profile, they're standard profiles, aren't they, that we can get from Unibox?
Yeah, so I've selected a one that angles the light back in towards the shelf. Could have gone with a flat one. We'll hold on to those. Thanks very much for them, Nick, for another project. And we'll see how easy it is to fix. There's a little trick at the end we'll come to.
There's a magnetic strip on
here. Just pinch me trick. Yeah, there you go.
I just got that one there. But I know what you're thinking, so let's get the camera out and have a little look at this. So we just finished the holiday season, and it looks like your all-inclusive wristband has still remained with you, Gordon. Can you talk me through what that is?
Okay, well, just remember when you're working with LED strip, you need to watch your static electricity, because that can actually damage the strip during the assembly process. So I've just got there. Check out that video.
Yeah, and again, we went through that. It's an unearthed video, but it might be by the time we release this one, we might have actually public released it. It'll probably be in the description below. It may be in the link above our heads. It's worth checking out that video in order that you can obviously not damage your LED strip when obviously you're working with it, just through simple things like static.
Yeah, so the other question I think we'll deal with before we get to just installing it, as a lot of people ask us, is about specifying a power supply for lead tape.
Okay, which is just here.
Yeah, which is just there. And so I went through the worked example here. We're going to light four shelves, and each length of LED strip is 650 millimeters long. So that gives us 2,600 millimeters, which is 2.6 meters. The strip we're going to use from Osram is 7 watts per meter squared,
okay.
So 2.6 times 7, 18.2 watts total for the whole installation. So looking at the driver, we're going to use 24 volts, so P equals VI, rearrange it to get I, so I equals the power divided by the voltage, so 18.2 watts divided by 24 volts. 0.76 amps.
Oh, well done. There we are in maths corner.
There we go.
So all we've done there is obviously work out the current, work out the power. I'm going to look on here and work out which one we need. And if I have a quick look at that, that says 20 watts to me.
Yeah, so there you go. So more than the 18.2 watts worked out. Okay. Just as well you put the glasses on there, Gary. That was
technical question for me. So what are you going to next then? Are you going to do a bit of soldering? Are you going
I've got a little bit of
soldering.
So the lead tape we're using there is the Osram short pitch.
We've seen before you're doing a little bit of soldering, so while you're working away, so we've seen you do a little bit of soldering before with the old solder mate. Check out that video, and we know that as it's an Osram tape, that it's always best to tin those pads before obviously inserting the conductors. So while you're trimming up here, the good people are currently seeing a video that can be seen onto the channel. So okay, you got that one sorted.
So
is it short pitch?
It's short pitch, so we're going to try and get as close as possible to the end of this to create a nice uniform light.
Okay.
So this is our profile, so I'll take that front diffuser off.
Okay, so that's off.
Nice sound.
And we talked in a previous video as well about the benefits of using a profile or attaching LED strip to a surface, because obviously it works as a heat sink. So this is going to work as a heat sink for our Osram strip.
So here's a top tip on this one, Gary.
Okay, yep.
The end caps from the extrusion.
Oh, right.
Make sure you thread the wire through them first, the feed-in wire.
Okay. Because having already made three off, I would suggest that was a painful experience from life.
There's an absolute top tip there.
Okay, so are you going to peel it off and stick it down then, or are you going to check
the
end?
No, so I'm going to put the solder the end on first.
In the end on with soldering.
Now it's solder, mate.
Okay, so in a previous video, I didn't help you here because I was a little shaky with the hand cam.
Yeah, now the good thing is these leads from Unibox, they're pre-tinned on the end.
Just keep it still, let's have a little look.
Pre-tinned.
Okay, yeah.
So I can...
Are you going to tin the pads, as I just said, or are you going to go straight in?
I'm going to go straight in, because they're quite small wires. And
they're already tinned, so you think you're going to tin the pads. Just have a little look there. So it just shows you how good that solder mate is. That's held those perfectly in place. But here we go. Moment of truth.
Thing off the iron. Use the spaceman's head.
So just getting some solder sorted out.
Yeah, try.
It's worth checking out. There is an unearthed video of me having a go at soldering, which is not worth watching. So we're using the old TS100 soldering iron. Have we done a video on that, Gordon?
We have.
Okay.
I've switched it on. Ah, it's gone to sleep because I've been
talking too much, Gordon, I would suggest.
Put that to 350 degrees.
And 350 is the required temperature for...
For this, for the Osram strip.
Yep.
I'll just let that warm up a bit.
Okay, so it's just warming up. Okay, so...
It doesn't take long.
So is it already there?
Yep, already
there.
Wow.
That's a good video, that video on the TS100. I'd recommend you check that out. Very inexpensive solder and iron you're using here, but it's very good for what we need it to do. So there we go. On those fingers again, you don't want the criticism, Gordon. Oh, you're in with your fingers again.
Yeah, so that's that done on there. Okay. So I'm going to switch the iron off now because a lot of leads.
Okay, so all so good so far. You got everything together. So you're now going to put it into the profile.
In the profile.
Get the lead tape in there. So peel off the back, sticks in, and as we said before in a previous video presentation, it works perfectly as a heat sink. Check out that one, because believe it or not, LEDs do create a lot of temperature, and we proved that in a video as well, didn't we, Gordon?
Yes.
Well, let's have a little look. Hang on, let's get a little closer. So if we stick that down.
So I'm going to go right to the end.
Right to the end, right?
Just start that off.
So peeling it back, and you think you're going to have this almost perfect the length of this short pitch.
I am, yeah.
So there's more cutting points on the short pitch. I think they're every 50 mil, according to the video we produced.
Yeah.
I know it changes with manufacturer.
Mil.
Okay, so here we go. You didn't check it, which I think is brave beforehand. So this might find that it doesn't work and you're going to be in the world of pain, Gordon. Well, that went in, that's actually the perfect length.
Perfect length.
Okay.
Remembered my end cap.
Yes, yeah, from experience, I would suggest, from
there.
Experience.
I've done that there, I'm going to lose my static
band.
Now,
okay. Right.
Check it on the power supply.
Check it now, are you?
Hopefully. Okay.
So just to remind you, there is a video where we cut LED strip in the wrong place. Okay, so we cut that in the wrong place and we saw that it caused us a massive issue, and some of those LEDs then didn't work when we cut it in the wrong place. So again, choosing the right LED strips, really important.
Yeah, so that works.
Okay, so that illuminated off camera. So we're going back. So you've done three more of these, and these are going to go on our shelves. So I know
shelf,
I mentioned the magnetic strip. I don't think our audience thought they were going to be held on by magic. Okay, so.
Yeah, so I've got that ready to go. I can stick that up there.
Okay.
So I've just got to prepare the driver.
The driver. So you're going to connect that into there?
Is that
a couple of ferruled ends I see there?
So I've already prepared that earlier, Gary.
We know
already
people love a ferrule at eFIXX. There we go, look, a couple of ferruled ends. Okay, and they're going to go into the driver itself. Make sure you get them right.
I'll try to get them right, Gary. I wouldn't.
Okay, we're on the wrong side. So connecting those in, and this is going to power the track. Is that right? Am I using the right words?
Yeah. So it's going to power a track that will take up to 8 amps, but obviously
we're using about 0.76. I think we're fine. So have a look back there. Yeah, 0.76 of an amp. So main supply going in. Are they ferruled ends as well? Or you move it too quick? Ferruled ends. Yep. Okay. Yep. Ferruled ends. Yeah. Brilliant.
Just handy for preparing leads to
ferrule stuff beforehand because it just stops them.
And again, if you haven't watched that video, there's several videos we've produced on the channel about the benefits of ferruling ends of cables, especially when they're stranded and fine stranded. But check out those videos, they're worth looking at. So you've connected that up.
Yeah, and this driver, this Optotronic driver from Osram, is nice. They used to call them the mouse back in the halogen days.
Okay.
And this end is also a cord grip as well.
Okay, so squeeze that one down. So this is going to power the track, and we're going to connect some sort of connection between the LED strips with those leads that you put on that will connect onto the actual track itself.
Yeah, so that's it. Right, so that's our driver.
Look at what you've got over
ready.
There we go, they're all prepared and ready to go.
So here's the clever bit. So this is a bus bar.
So that's what I'm calling the track. You're calling it a bus
bar? Yeah, it's a bit, think of it a bit like a bus bar. So it's a slightly flexible PCB. Again, on the back, here's the clever bit. It's got a magnetic strip.
Okay, makes sense.
And here's our connectors are just going to sit on. Now, these connectors, if you get close in here, I've got tiny little spring-loaded contacts.
Ah, okay.
So when we introduce that to the track, and it's going to magnetize to the steel of the shelving and connect itself to the track itself.
Very clever.
So that's clever. That is clever. And if you wanted to extend this,
okay,
so you had a longer track, you can get these extension pieces as well. So they're just joining bits.
Ah, so there's four of them. Yeah, yeah, makes sense. And again, it will be magnetized down, but joining two tracks together. Again, even though I've joined two tracks together, would that be still an 8-amp rated value?
Yeah, so it's still 8 amps. It's the conductors on the track that are doing it. Right, so here's for the fast installation.
Okay, so let's see. So let's put it onto shelving cam. So you're going to come over to here.
Yeah.
And what are you going to do for me?
Well, I'm going to use the fact we've got an upright that's made of steel.
So just remind me, that's the track going on there?
That's the track going in there. I'm going to power up that track.
That's the track stuck to the outside. Okay, and then you're going to power it up.
Yep, so I connect that onto there.
I'll have a look at that in a minute. And then you're going to simply plug this in, and that will be the track livened up.
That will be the track livened up.
Okay, so have a little look at that. So we come around here, and we've got that connected like so. Yeah, makes sense. Wouldn't matter where you put it on the track, is that true? So you don't have to put it at the bottom end, you can put it in the middle.
At the bottom end. As we progress the installation here, we'll probably move it multiple times. So there's the units I've assembled.
Okay.
With the magnetic strip on the back. So just put that under there on our shelf.
Okay.
The other bit, it's got these little magnetic cable clips as well.
Like
so we can we can hide them in there.
Got his own little clips.
And put it around the right way.
And because it's, there you go.
Job done. So that's one shelf done.
Okay. Well, I'll see why I didn't get this job. It's really easy. So you can just bring them over to me. I notice we've got a couple of the Muppets on the screen. Is there any stories beyond that, Gordon?
Someone did say the other week that, we look like the, we're a bit like the Muppets. So.
Is that the right way around?
It is on what I've done, so.
I think it's round the wrong way, Gordon.
Yeah, what have I done there? I've brought the wire in at the wrong end. So, okay, we'll deal with that off camera.
Okay, so that's going to be angled the other way, is it?
That's going to be angled the other way.
All right.
Lesson learned there.
Yeah, so put that one on. Okay, but we've obviously got that on there. That one's angled back, so we can see the difference. So that's angled back into whatever products we would have been
back
putting
in,
on
so
the
we'll
shelf
get some
here.
Glare.
This one's angled forward. So we've got this one.
Does magnets grip onto anything?
Yep, so that one's going to be in. It's, incredibly simple system. And a lovely bit of light. There we go. So is this the last one?
The last one,
yeah. So it gives us four of these Konnect Hive system, yeah.
Yep.
So that one's on, pop it onto the actual track itself.
Yeah.
Let me have a look at the side piece. Ah, you just moved the supply up there.
Yeah.
I like that, so that one's on as well. Let's have a quick look around here at these connections. So that's just simply magnetic on the sides. It finds a position on the track, and you can see on the camera off. And now we position it, we've got it on. Wow.
There we go, job done.
So which sector do you think this would most benefit from this form of lighting?
I mean, Unibox's background is retail, and that's what they've designed it for, retail shelving. you know, retailers move the shelves a lot, change displays, quick setup. But what you don't want to do is be, you know, with that bus bar track at the back, you've just got total flexibility to add as many or few items as you need. You can do a first fix install, and then it's, yeah, it's a non-technical install.
Just about to say that. Yeah, the person that's changing the lighting after the electrician's set the system up doesn't necessarily need a huge amount of technical competency to actually configure the lights accordingly.
Yeah.
Which makes it very, very versatile. So anything else you want to draw into the conversation from stuff we've done in previous videos and what we've done here, Gordon?
No, so I mean, that's it. Hopefully we've showed you how to quickly check the power you need for a driver. This will be sitting in the background of a lot of our videos now, so you can check if my soldering actually lasts and goes the distance. Yeah, watch out for those shelves in the background, and we've got some more lights to add to the set as we go along. We're going to add some colour change in some videos coming up as well.
Loving that. So we've got a huge amount of videos that were almost covered in this one. We've done stuff on ferrules, we've done the soldering iron review on the TS100, do you agree?
TS100.
We've looked at static, we've looked at cutting LED strip, we've looked at short pitch, we looked at the two different voltages that are commonly used, being 12 and 24, and when you'd use those. All those videos will be in play. List. Hopefully you'll put them in the description or in the end cards at the end of this presentation. I recommend you check those out, and we're always interested in your feedback, so make sure you leave your comments below, and Gordon will try and get back to as many as he can.